Howdy guys, Marty Scribner here at AMS Ducati Dallas, and today we're bringing you the absolute pinnacle of the Ducati brand, the apex of World Superbike currently. This is the 2023 Panigale R model. And when we were talking about making this video, we were gonna do, you know, mostly just the, I'd say, big picture, shock and awe, take a look at it, it's beautiful. But when you start to dive into what the factory in Bologna has done to this motorcycle, I had to break out the trusty, remarkable notepad and just make sure I go through a couple things that are quite technical, but I thought you would wanna know about this motorcycle, what makes it special, why is it far above any of the other bikes. When I first started working here 15 years ago, as a much younger person with no gray hair, I was full of ego, super proud of the brand because I worked here. And I would tell you, any Ducati is the best bike. There's nothing like it. And then as the years went on, we had some pretty rough patches in obviously World Superbike, MotoGP. There were a couple models that had issues, i.e. like plastic tanks that had swelling issues, things like that. So, you know, we had some trials to go through. But when I tell you today, sitting in front of you, standing in front of you in May of 2023, that I truly believe nothing can touch this motorcycle. It's coming from 15 years of experience, and I still have humility and respect for all the manufacturers. Everybody makes a great product, but holy mackerel, this thing is intense. When you start to look at what the factory has done for their customers on this motorcycle. And if you factor in that this is sitting in right now, this day and age, at about $45,000, I'm kind of blown away with what you're getting in this package. When I think back to when I bought a 1098R in 2008 for $40,000. So for $5,000 more, when you start to dive into this bike, I think you're also gonna be blown away in agreement with me. So let's just start talking about this motorcycle. Let's dive in to some of the juicy facts. So yes, it's stunning. We've got the number one plates. I appreciate you, Alvaro Bautista. Thank you very much for winning the world title. So it makes a little bit more sense for the factory to put these number one plates on there. So yes, it's gorgeous, but this bike is powered by a 998cc V4 motor, the Desmo Stradale. And this R model is very unique and goes above and beyond the standard and S model and your SP models. So we had those couple of years, right, where we didn't need to make the R model. We came out with the SP, came out with the SP2. Those had a dry clutch on them. They had carbon wheels and some carbon bits and some rear sets. This thing is on an absolutely different planet. So it's right at that 1000cc mark, so we can go racing. 998cc's. This bike dry, it's dry weight, no fuel in it. It's 379 pounds. That's, you know, no fluids. Your curb weight is 427 pounds, sopping wet. That's with the almost 4.5 gallon gas tank full. It's just below 4.5 on its capacity. So that 1000cc bike right out of the crate in homologation dressing, so 100% street legal, you're looking at 218 horsepower out of the crate. This bike in front of you does have the full Akrapovic titanium race exhaust installed. The bike does not come with that, so that is an addition to this bike. But we wanted to make sure and do a video with it in proper form here, so you've got the full race exhaust. So as this bike sits right now with the what I'll call normal shell oil from the factory, with the full race exhaust, you're looking at 237 horsepower with this exhaust. So the bike's gonna start out with 82 foot-pounds of torque at the correct RPM, and now we're at 87 foot-pounds of torque. So 237 horsepower, pretty much ridiculous. We'll just go ahead and say it. That's pretty ludicrous. So the reason I'm talking about the exhaust and normal oil very carefully is I'm immediately gonna mention what most people have asked about. So let's just go ahead and nip it in the bud right now. Everybody sees this figure on the Ducati website or in the advertisements of 240, slightly over 240 horsepower on this motorcycle. The way you're going to achieve that is the full race exhaust, and then you're going to put in the special Ducati Corsa partnering with Shell oil. So there is a very fancy motion lotion that they've made, not specifically for this bike, but that they have ready and available to go in this motorcycle. That special motion lotion, that race oil that can go in here, you're looking at about at base level, because it's, I think it's reducing 10%, and I'm just gonna check the figures on that. It's a 10% reduction in mechanical friction. So when it comes to performance, if we wanna base it off of horsepower, you're looking at an increase, a base increase of 3.5 horsepower just because of that oil. And at max rev, you're looking at top horsepower gain, 4.5. So 3.5 to 4.5 horsepower just because of the oil and that reduction in friction. So the big exclamation point, the big asterisk next to that though is just know, and if you're into this kind of toy, you would already expect it. If you're gonna do that special oil, you're on a totally different maintenance oil change interval. So if I were in that situation, I have this bike, the full race exhaust, the oil, you best believe I'm changing the oil every single track day. So had a great Sunday, you know, put in however many miles, I don't really care how many minutes or miles it was, I did one track day, I'm changing the oil. So I have not seen that interval listed anywhere, any nomenclature for that, but just know there's gonna be a high frequency oil change and a price to pay for that race oil. All right, so moving on, talk about the exhaust and the oil. Some really special items attached to this motorcycle. The first thing I'm gonna do, we're gonna travel here in the showroom a little bit. We'll get it out of the way. There is a dry STM clutch that comes with this motorcycle, and you can see it on the bike. This is a new and improved lighter STM dry clutch than you're used to, so it's not the same one. So you can see here, my thumb fits here in the case of the motor, and there's your dry slipper clutch. And just for example, to give you a comparison, if we step over to this SP Street Fighter, here's what you'd find in an SP Panigale, SP2 Panigale. You can see the difference here with those perimeter, the plates on the perimeter here. So we've got a lighter weight dry clutch on this motorcycle. The pistons on this motorcycle are lighter. They have a different shape to them. The pistons are unique to this motorcycle. I can't remember how many grams, but you have a lighter piston. On the piston skirt itself, the Ducati factory spent some big bucks. The piston skirt is DLC coated. So for village idiots like me, that means diamond-like carbon. So a special coating on the piston skirts. Pretty crazy stuff. Also reducing weight. Everyone would expect it. Yes, it has the lithium ion battery. So you can tell Ducati front to back, we could talk about numerous things. How do we reduce weight on this motorcycle? And then with the reduction of weight, after that, how are we gonna make it handle? So up front, you have the pressurized 43 mil Ohlins front forks. That's the NPX 43 mil front forks. And you can see the pressurized, you can see the charge here, this on the front forks. We've had that on a few models, so obviously the R model is gonna get that. You're also looking at, if my figures are correct, 5 millimeters more travel on the front. Definitely gonna help you on the front end on the handling there. If you tie that extra 5 mil on the front with the fact that they've given us what we typically expect on an R model trim, our swing arm, our pivot position, has a variable there. You can actually change it. So for you hardcore track day guys, if this bike's just gonna live on the track, if you go from a tight technical track where you wanna feel the wheelbase, theoretically, I'll say shorten, but really what you're doing is gonna raise the ride height. on this motorcycle. And by the way, this ride height is already taller than the standard Panigale, but you can change that swing arm pivot position to have the bike either feel like it's raised up and be more agile and change direction easier, or you can change it to where it's a longer footprint, and when you are coming out of the corner cranked over, you're going to be more like a flat link style rear end, where you're going to be able to put that power down. But obviously there's going to be more energy going into that rear tire, and you're going to be dealing with understeer, oversteer. So whether it's a big sweeping track or it's a short, tight technical circuit, you have this available to you to adapt to that track with the swing arm pivot. So pretty awesome stuff. And just above that pivot position I was talking about is that Ohlins TTX. This isn't the typical Ohlins TTX that I'd show you in our videos. Just below the clicker for compression and rebound, if you visit your dealership and they have one, or if you look closely online, you've got the hydraulic spring preload adjuster there. So an extremely impressive rear TTX shock for you. So there's no excuses for you not to be able to handle anything the track's showing at you. Pretty awesome stuff. A couple more mechanical or physical things, and then I want to dive into some of the electronics on this bike and hopefully not be too long-winded and take too much of your day. So I know we're all busy these days. So new camshaft profile, so it's lifting a little bit more. We talked about the pistons. Oh my gosh. Okay, so the titanium conrods. So there is a 1.6 millimeter gun drilled channel through the conrod. So directly through the center of that conrod, 1.6 mil, there's a vein that they've drilled out. So obviously at the base, you've got your pin and the bushing or the sleeve there. This channel, I'll just call it a vein, if you will, that gun drilled conrod, we're getting more oil displacement, so it can travel more. So we're keeping everything lubed up in high intensity situations like track days that you would want on an R model. So I believe that's the first time that's been done for a street production bike. You're gonna see that in high end racing, but it's a gun drilled conrod, super cool. Your exhaust valves are steel, but your intake valves are titanium. Pretty cool stuff there. And then, yeah, we could just keep diving in. Obviously the crank, I mean, everything about the motor is just, it's pretty cool to call it a Ducati, because it seems like SpaceX, you know, astronaut stuff. This bike is obviously ready to race, and I can't stop drooling over it. Now, let's step away from the mechanical stuff. Let's talk a little bit about electronics. As you'd expect, there's been a few tweaks to the quick shifter and the way it performs, whether you're lugging around town at slow speeds, or if you're in a high rev, they've tweaked the Ducati quick shifter a little bit to make it smoother for day to day, but also more efficient on the track. You're gonna have the latest engine braking control, EBC, as you'll see on the website or in the nomenclature. Obviously, we've got our wheelie control, our traction control, our slide control. That entire electronic package is here, along with the Ducati, well, what we call the DDA, so that's the data analyzer. So back in the day, you'd get 30 laps in a few sessions. I think we now can record a total of 60 laps and 6 sessions, if I'm correct. Don't quote me on that, but it's right around there that it's gonna store. So you have a DDA, but this DDA is also partnering with this bike, comes with the GPS module. So you take a 2 to 3 intermediate laps around your track. Those first laps, that GPS, that DDA is gonna see you complete that loop, complete that lap. And now the rider is no longer responsible for hitting the high beam button to do a new lap. The bike is gonna GPS lap time you. You're gonna be able to see lean angle. You're gonna be able to see both axis, Y and X. So pitch up and down, lean side to side, when you're using the bike, when you're not using the bike in different sectors. One cool thing on the dash, they've already preloaded for you in the DDA some of the most world famous tracks, like Jerez, Mugello, and so on. So pretty cool stuff. I can show you that on a dash in a different video. So we got the DDA, you've got all your electronics. Some of you may have not been able to see this, and I'll get the camera to check out the dash real quick. So out of the crate, race A and race B are in what we call track Evo layout now. So I'm gonna get my phalange in here. So you have a big green bar in the upper left. That is gonna be a shift indicator. The upper right over here is the red rev limiter light. And in track Evo, when one of your rider's aids activates and is helping you, it'll be a color-coded bar. So as you can see here, orange DTC, wheelie control is blue, slide control is green, so on and so on. So they will light up, letting you know that they are currently helping you. And then on top of that, you can, you would be able to change these guys while riding. So if you're like, man, wheelie control is really slow in my drive, I'm not really wheeling because I have a counter-rotating crankshaft, I can afford to get my wheelie control down to one, you can change that on the fly. The other mode is what we're the Ducati community is pretty used to. You're gonna find in your sport street modes. So I'll go into sport here for you. And now you can see what we're kind of used to. Sport mode is in the track layout. So from 6,000 RPMs to one to the start of the tack, we've condensed that because you should not be down there. So you're more concerned with where am I in the power band. So we're gonna condense that. In the lowest mode, which Ducati equates to 160 horsepower, that's street mode, which for me would be like wet mode. They're saying it's 160 horsepower, and out of the crate, your tack is completely even on the spread. So from 1 to 16 and a half, it's even. Let's talk about the revs real quick. So it's a 998cc. The standard and S model Panigales, they're 1100cc's. They redline at 14 and a half. This R model, in sixth gear, revs to 16,500 RPMs. Pretty crazy. In any other gear, first through fifth, it's gonna redline at 16,000. So you get an extra 500 when you're in that top gear. So if you're at Circuit of the Americas going down the straight, you've got an extra 500 there to tap out on if you've got guts to do that on this motorcycle. Pretty crazy. Yeah, so we talked about the riding modes, but also just remember we've added a few different power profiles on the mapping, right? So it's no longer just low, medium, high. There's now a full. So that full is, I just call it full tilt boogie, because guess what? We're not holding back at all. So high still remains, but you're gonna get a little bit of a different programming there. Full is like, guess what? It's up to you, let's see what you got. So within the profiles, you'll see there's a couple extras there. Yes, so gone over the motor. We've talked about the suspension. Obviously, it's the most beautiful bike on the road. Pretty insane stuff on this motorcycle. If I didn't hit anything, you can always reach out to your local dealer. Reach out to us, AMS Ducati Dallas. We'd love to help you out if you've got any questions on the R model. If you see one in a dealership, if your dealer is playing the game correctly, that means this bike is already sold. So this customer's coming in today to take ownership of this motorcycle, but you can still get on the list and hope to obtain one of these just elite master pieces of a motorcycle. I mean, I can't get over this motorcycle. And then obviously the internet never does it justice, but we probably wanna go ahead and hear this thing purr for a little bit. I'll start it up just to show some appreciation for you hanging in there with me. Hopefully you didn't fast forward through all that. Appreciate you guys stopping by. Thanks for listening to me talk.